In this video series about how to teach remotely, I'm showcasing different lesson plans as well as free technology resources for you to use when teaching your students online. In this video, I'm going to show you some new ideas for how to use a Google Slides Hyperdoc for remote teaching. I strongly believe that creating a Hyperdoc with Google Slides or Google Docs is one of the absolute best ways to create a rigorous, engaging, and creative independent study project for your students to work on in distance learning. In addition to the Google Slides Hyperdoc and Google Docs note takers, I'll also be showing you how to use Coggle, which is an online note taker, as well as Book Creator, which is one of my favorite programs for having students make a creative project and then showcasing that project to their peers. My name is Sam Kary, and this is my YouTube channel for the new EdTech classroom. As always, you can find all the resources that I show in this video on my website at www.newedtechclassroom.com. And if you find the tips that I share in this video helpful, I'd appreciate it if you hit the like button, share it with other teachers that you know, and consider subscribing to my channel and hitting the notification bell to make sure you don't miss any of my weekly video updates. In this video, I'm going to be showing you a distance learning Hyperdoc that my partner teacher, Amy Heckman, and I created last week that my students did during remote learning. Like the other Hyperdoc that I showed in my other video, my partner teacher and I used Google Slides when creating this document. In some future videos, I'm also going to be showing how to use Google Docs to create a Hyperdoc as well. When I make my Hyperdocs for students, I'm giving them a week-long lesson plan. I post the Hyperdoc to Google Classroom by clicking File, Make a Copy, so that each student has an individual copy that they are able to use for themselves. I teach sixth grade humanities, and we're in our China unit, so this lesson plan is going to be about the achievements of the Han Dynasty. I do believe that all the concepts and programs that I'm going to be showing you could be applicable across any subject at any grade level. After the title screen, you'll notice that I'm going to begin this Hyperdoc with a link to a Screencastify video in order to provide my students with an overview of the entire week's project. Most of my lesson plans are made in Screencastify, and at this point, I'm only using live video meetings for question and answer sessions. I actually prefer Screencastify as a method to teach and explain a lesson because students and families can watch it whenever they need to and can re-watch sections if they need to. I have a whole separate tutorial about how to use Screencastify for video tutorials that you might want to check out. Next, I'm always going to include our essential question for the week so that students understand the main topic that they are going to be learning about. Then I'm going to emphasize the specific learning targets that students will be working on in this lesson. In this lesson plan, students will be researching about the Han Dynasty and then using a program called Coggle in order to take notes. Then they'll be applying their knowledge by drafting an argumentative paragraph about which Han Dynasty achievements they believe are the most important. Whether in my physical classroom or online, I almost always end the week by having students create something to process what they've learned. In this case, students will be using a program called Book Creator to create digital books that they can then share in a class library for the rest of their classmates to see. And then to wrap the week up, students are going to read each other's digital books and then post their reactions back to Google Classroom. I always think it's incredibly important to have students showcasing the work that they've created with their classmates. In the case of remote teaching, having students share their work is going to be one way to help students maintain a sense of class community. This Hyperdoc is going to be structured using the 5E's lesson plan, which I go over in greater depth in another video about how to lesson plan with Google Slides. You'll notice that I'm breaking the slides up now based on days of the week in order to really orient my students to what they need to do on a particular day. On Monday, I'm going to start by generating some interest. So here, students are going to watch a quick video on the Mr. Granito's channel that summarizes the Han Dynasty in under 5 minutes to give them an overview. For this phase of the lesson, the note taker is going to be really simple. In this case, it's just a T-chart about new facts that students learned and questions that they have. You could also consider doing something like a KWL chart here. One question that came up a lot in the previous video that I made about how to teach remotely with a Google Slides Hyperdoc is how to deal with document management when you include a hyperlink to a Google Doc that you've created. The problem that comes up is that if you click File, Make a Copy of the Google slide, unfortunately, it's not also going to make a copy of the document that's hyperlinked. I definitely was not clear enough in that previous video to emphasize that you're going to need to teach students that they need to click File, Make a Copy, and then share that document with their teacher so that you're able to actually view it. You'll notice on this slide that there's a box below where students can paste the link to the document that they created so that when they turn this document in, it's all self-contained in one place. If you want to bypass the issue of having students make a copy altogether, which is something I'm trying to do to the best of my ability, you can also just directly embed a graphic organizer onto a Google slide and have them type directly on it. On Tuesday, students will enter the explore step of the lesson, which will involve them using different resources to learn about the topic we're studying. Here I've included links to three excellent resources for teachers. The first is Newzella. Newzella is a great resource because it automatically levels texts based on a student's reading level. It's also usually not a free program, but right now Newzella has been made free for teachers to use through the end of the school year. Then I've included a link to a history.com article about the Han Dynasty, as well as a Britannica article. Then students are going to log into a program called Coggle in order to take notes. Coggle is a free program that you and your students can use to make bubble diagrams or take other types of digital notes. Here you'll see I've given students an option to either use a pre-created Coggle template that I created for them, or they can make one on their own. The benefit of using the pre-created template is that sometimes adding all the branches and bubbles can be difficult for some students. It might also depend on the grade level that you teach. So let's jump in and take a quick look at what Coggle is all about. When you first log into Coggle, you'll see that you're given an option to make either a concept map or a mind map. And it really doesn't matter which one of those you pick. When you're ready to create a diagram, go up to Create Diagram, and there you'll see that you have a main idea box in the middle that you can easily edit. So if I'm creating a template for my students, I'm going to write Han Dynasty achievements in the middle of my diagram. And then in order to add my first main idea, I'm going to click the plus button to add a new branch. You'll see here that the branch can be moved around, resized, and you can also change the color to be whatever you would like. To guide my students, I'll pre-type one of the major achievements of the Han Dynasty in this box. And if I wanted to make it a little bit more interesting, I could also add an image here as well. To do that, you're first going to need to go find your image. And then to add it to the diagram, all you'll need to do is click on the image icon, click upload an image, find the image, and then to get the image to show up, you just need to click off of the box. In order to add additional branches so that students are able to add specific details about that achievement, all I need to do is click on the plus button, and then I can add as many supplemental branches as I want and drag them and resize them wherever I want them to go. So now you can see the finished example of the template that I created and pushed out to students. To be able to access the template and then include it as a hyperlink on your slide, just go up to Share This Diagram, click Embed, then copy that link and paste it back into your Google Slides Hyperdoc. You'll see that there's a question that students can click on at the bottom that will remind them of all the different commands that they would have to use in order to do different things like deleting branches or adding new ones. So here you can see an actual example of a Coggle note taker that a student completed in my class for this project. In order to submit it, all this student had to do was go up to the embed link on their Coggle and then paste it back into the slide presentation. That detail might be something you would want to include in a Screencastify tutorial or a midweek question and answer session that you host with your students. As an extension, students can do additional research and can add additional notes to their note taker. On Wednesday, for the explain phase of the lesson, students are going to take the information that they just took notes on in Coggle and make an argument about what they believe the most important achievements of the Han Dynasty were. Here I've included a hyperlink to a graphic organizer for students to organize their writing. You'll notice I've also included sentence frames for students. I think it's particularly important to provide students with some sentence starters with remote teaching so that they can get a better sense of the academic language that they need to be using for a particular assignment. On Thursday, for the creative part of the lesson, students will be making a digital book or an ebook in one of my favorite programs, Book Creator. I have a whole separate tutorial about how to use Book Creator that I've also linked here for my students to be able to watch to remind them of how to use the major features of the program. Notice that I've included specific instructions about what needs to be included in their digital books, and I've also provided students with an extension option to include additional multimedia files like audio, drawing, and video. So here you can see in Book Creator all the digital books that students made and added to our class library. The student view looks almost identical to what you see now. I love that students can click on each other's books and read what their peers have created. Publishing their work for the rest of the class is a great way to retain a sense of class community and also help students feel like the work that they're doing still really matters because it's going to be seen by their classmates. Book Creator offers 40 free books and one library. There are upgrade options in order to have additional books and have additional libraries. Lastly, on Friday for the extend phase, students are going to read each other's digital books in Book Creator and then use academic sentence starters to post comments back to Google Classroom about the information that was in those books. So here you can see my students engaging in a conversation on Google Classroom about whether they agree or disagree with the major achievements of the Han Dynasty that their peers selected. And then to cap it off, I had students take some of the agree comments and add them to the back cover of their books to make it a little bit more authentically like a real book jacket. This final slide is just a reminder for students to go back and proofread all of their work to make sure all the supplemental documents that they linked back onto the slides are shared with their teacher, and then to make sure that they hit turn in on Google Classroom. I hope you found this video helpful and that it gave you some ideas for how you might approach remote teaching with your students. If you have any questions or other suggestions, I'd love to hear about them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching my video to the end. If you found the tips that I shared helpful, please share it with other teachers that you know, hit the like button, and subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss any of my weekly updates. You can also check out some of the other tutorials I have on my channel by clicking on one of those two videos above. And if you're interested in downloading any of the resources that I've created and show on my videos, please visit my website at www.newedtechclassroom.com. Lastly, if you want to check me out on social media, my Twitter handle, Facebook page, and Pinterest account are all in the description below. Thanks so much and have a great week.